morning, sir.
Good morning, madam. My name is K. Harshavardhan Reddy, studying 7th class in section in ZPHS Sarvanagar. My project is aquaponics. The world is facing a number of serious problems like population rise, climate change, soil degradation, water scarcity and food security. So, and etc. many more. For this all problems, aquaponics is one of the solution. What is aquaponics? Aquaponics is a combination of aquaculture means fish farming and hydroponics, soilless plant culture. Aquaponics is the cultivation of fish and vegetables together in a constructed way, a recirculating ecosystem utilizing natural bacterial cycles to convert fish waste into plant nutrients as shown in this. In aquaponics system, the nutrient-rich water from the fish is a source of natural fertilizer for the growing plants. As the plants consume these nutrients and purifies this water and again fish this fish tank. This creates a sustainable ecosystem where both plants and fish can thrive. History of aquaponics. Aquaponics was started in the 14th century only by the Azhagta people. They cultivated their agricultural lands and called them as chinampas. And in southern China, Thailand and Indonesia, because of overpopulation, they grew this aquaponics in the paddies with fish. Now, I want to tell something more about plants and fish. What do plants and fish need to live? Plants need light, water, carbon dioxide, nitrates or nutrients. And fish need food, clean water and oxygen. In this sustainable ecosystem, plants have to give something to the fishes and fishes also have to give something to the plants. Means, plants give oxygen and sugars through photosynthesis and clean the water in which the fish lives. And the fish releases waste in the form of ammonia and carbon dioxide through respiration. Now, I want to tell something about carbonic cycle and nitrogen cycle. Here you can see the diagram. Plants take in carbon dioxide and produce oxygen and sugars through photosynthesis. And the fish consume and breathe in oxygen and fish produce carbon dioxide through respiration. Now, nitrogen cycle. Bacteria plays an important role in nitrogen cycle through a natural process. The cycle is broken down as follows. Here you can see. First, we feed food to fishes and fish excrete ammonia and bacteria eats ammonia and converts into nitrite NO2 and which is then converted into nitrate NO3. Nitrate happens to be the favorite food of plants and again the plant give oxygen to fishes. This cycle also repeats. And how aquaponics works? In the same way, we feed food to fishes and fish produce ammonia rich waste. Too much waste substance is toxic for fishes. The bacteria which is cultured in the fish tanks and the grow beds break down this ammonia into nitrite and then to nitrate. Plants, then the water is taken to the plants and the plants consume these nitrates as nutrients and the grow bed or the plant roots purifies this water and again sends back to this fish tank. Now, I want to tell some advantages of aquaponics. The first one is water reuse, space and production efficiency, biosecurity, aquaponic is organic, aquaponic farms are ecologically sustainable, aquaponic farms are more efficient than the other forms of fish farming. And here you can see the first point, water reuse. Aquaponic systems are completely contained systems that reuse most of the water and wastes are removed, water is treated and recycled back to the tank. Water loss during the waste removal or evaporation is typically 1 to 1.5% of the total volume of water. And space and production efficiency. The productivity is higher than the conventional aquaculture. Market size fish can be grown in 9 months in aquaponics, but in conventional method it takes 15 to 18 months. For example, it takes 197.6 acres of open ponds to produce the same amount of shrimp that an aquaponic can produce on just 6.1 acres of land. Biosecurity. Aquaponic fish farms are fully closed and controlled. They operate without any inputs like drugs, chemicals or antibiotics, and therefore it is biosecure as pests and diseases and parasites cannot get into the system. This ensures a more natural product for the consumers. Aquaponic systems can be located within urban communities that will use a fish rather than by natural resources like oceans or rivers, thus having a smaller carbon footprint due to reduced transportation requirements. Need not be located on water supply systems or for drainage requirements. Now the fourth one, aquaponic is organic. As long it is ensured that the fish food is organic, the fish and vegetables produced using aquaponic technologies can therefore be classified as organic products. Aquaponic farms are ecologically sustainable, means aquaponic farm can produce more, for example, the same amount of lettuce as traditional agriculture using half amount of water plus producing fish can be done in aquaponics. And the last one, aquaponic farms are more efficient than the other forms of fish farming, means they provide better quality products with higher growth rates, diverse revenue streams, scalability, array of products and flexibility of land. Now disadvantages. Everything has disadvantages in it. Aquaponic also has some disadvantages. The first one is high initial cost, means to fill up the water tank and to build the system like greenhouse, berms, etc. And the second one is require skill and know-how. For building the system or for organizing it, we should have some knowledge about it. And constant monitoring of water parameters means for beer. We have to check daily the water pH value and the temperature of the water. Pests and diseases can be devastating. Limitations concerned with fish species rate means there are some special fishes to be raised in this aquaponics and competitive market prices. Here you can see this is the table. These are the advantages of aquaponic systems and the problems with soil-based gardening, hydroponics and intensive aquaculture. Before only I said that there are some special fishes and plants to be grown in aquaponics. These are the fishes. The first one is goldfish, carp, barramundi, jade perch, tilapia and silver perch. And the plants like any leafy lettuce, mint, basil, most common house plants, tomatoes, peppers, cucumbers, beans. Here you can see these pictures and broccoli, cabbage, etc. Now types of aquaponics. There are three types of aquaponics. The first one is raft system. In a raft system, means it is also called as float, deep channel and deep flow. The plants are grown on styrofoam boards that float on the top of water. Water flows continuously from the fish tank through the filtration component and to the raft tank where the plants are grown and again back to this fish tank. Media filled bed. A tank or container is taken and filled with gravel, perlite or the media for the plant bed. This bed is periodically flooded from the water from the fish tank and again drains back to this fish tank. This method uses fewest components and no additional filtration is required, making it simple to operate. Nutrient film technique, NFT. NFT is a method in which the plants are grown on a long narrow channels. A thin film of water flows continuously from the fish tank through the and providing the plant roots with water, nutrients and oxygen, assuring this. Now here you can see this is the traditional type of farming. This is horizontal farming and vertical. Vertical farming is more productive in aquaponics because it occupies very less space. And other possibilities. Aquaponic can be grown in indoors, means here underground and indoors, but they need artificial lighting and they may be a life savior in post-apocalyptic scenarios. And the another one is growing upwards. This is the futuristic concept of aquaponics. They can be grown locally and dedicate skyscraper farms and make use of limited space. And here you can see this is the graph showing the production of aquaponics. And this is also the comparisons of aquaponics. These are the technique and production period for comparison and study. And now I will tell you how to build a 3 square feet aquaponic system. First one, we need a trough, means a solid plastic container for growing the plants, and the raft, means a styrofoam board, and water pump and air pump that are inside the fish tank, and the plants are planted out and the fishes are inside the fish tank. We need a fish tank more than 40 liters and it should be in good condition, no holes inside it. Now the procedure. The first and the second images are showing hooking the intake tube into the bottom of the growing trough, means that will take the water from the fish tank and again to this raft tank. And the third and fourth one, hooking the water line, means hooking the water line to the pump, means the pump will be inside this trough, means fish tank. The water, the pump takes the water and pump it to the raft tank. And the fifth one is the hooking of short PVC pipe that will drop the water back again to this fish tank. Now we are ready to add our fishes. See here, we are adding the fishes and we have cut our raft in a way that netted pot should fit inside it. Here you can see the now our aquaponic system is ready. And thoughts and questions. These are the questions when I read this aquaponics, I got these questions. What is aquaponics? How does aquaponics work? What types of fish and vegetables can you raise? And what is nitrogen cycle? What are the pros and cons? Carbonic cycle? And I explained you everything. And case studies. Here you can see this is the case studies. Many people in our country and our world did this aquaponics. The first one is Mr. Anish Chandra's rooftop aquaponics system. He did it at Kolkata. He did the NFT and media field bed systems. And this is also one of the school in Hyderabad, Donald Memorial High School. They too did the NFT system. And here we can see he is a farmer, Vishwanath Raju, field at Mahbub Nagar in Telangana. He did aquaponic and he became Adarsha Raitu for our Telangana. And conclusion, aquaponic systems are not only eco-friendly, sustainable, provide food security and create sustainable livelihoods, but they are also commercially feasible and make good business sense, especially in the world of dwindling and escalating of natural resources like land and water. Thank you. Presentation done by Master K. Harshavardhan Reddy, 7th Class C Section, Jilla Parishad High School, Sarur Nagar. Thank you. I hope you like this.